A new book offers an updated look at how close we are to finding out if alien life really exists. It's written by Adam Frank, an astrophysicist who was one of the first alien investigators for NASA.
The Little Book of Aliens explores the latest research in the search for intelligent life beyond Earth, and Adam joins us now. Adam, thanks for being with us.
Oh, it's a real pleasure. Thank you for having
me on.
It's interesting that the government's talking about this now, and it's much more in the open. I'm wondering what your science background is bringing to this discussion.
Well, you know, I wrote the book because after 30 years of being an astrophysicist, studying everything from, you know, how stars form to how planets form, I wanted people to understand how much the actual science of looking for life in the universe, how close we are to finding it. And that's very different from the UFO and UAP stuff, which I also cover in the book. So I wanted people to have a fast, fun way to see really that we may be the last generation that doesn't know the answer to the question, are we alone?
So Adam, don't we have cameras and detection 24/7 around our solar system. Is it possible for something to slip by us? And do you happen to know if the government has evidence of something alien that they can't explain?
Yeah, so that's one of the reasons, you know, I wanted people, I go through this in the book, that really there's no evidence when it comes to UFOs and UAPs that would really link to anything that is, not from this solar system. But with our telescopes, with the new telescopes like the James Webb Space Telescope, we actually can see into the atmospheres of alien worlds, you know, light years away. And that's where we're so close. The next 10 years or so, 20 years, we're going to have real data relevant to that question. We're going to be able to have something to say about whether or not life has started anywhere else in the universe, not in our own skies, because, you know, people have been saying this for years. We're really not any closer than we've ever been before for that. But actually finding alien life on alien planets, that's what people need to understand how close we are to.
So when you say life on other planets, are you talking about, you know, we see a puddle of water on Jupiter and we might see an amoeba forming? Or are you talking about someone waving back from another planet? I mean, talk about when you talk about life out there.
Both, actually. You know, okay. What we're going to be able to do, the NASA grant, so I'm the principal investigator, as we call it, on NASA's first grant to study how to find intelligent life on distant worlds, worlds that are 40 light years away or more. And what we're going to be able to do is we're either going to be able to find evidence for things like forests, you know, what we call a biosphere, you know, just like lots and lots of quote unquote dumb life. Or we could also find evidence for things like smart life, intelligent life in terms of city lights. We might be able to see the artificial illumination on the night side of the planet, or the evidence for industrial chemicals in the atmosphere of those worlds. And we're like so close to being able to do that. So people need to understand, on top of what's going on with UFOs, which is really mostly hype, I'm all for doing an open, transparent investigation, but it's really mostly hype. But what's really happening is we're about to find evidence one way or the other about whether life exists where it should be, which is on alien planets.
The history of civilizations clashing usually does not go well for somebody. Could this be a terrible idea? Is it more beneficial for us to find them before they find us?
Yeah, that's a great question. And, I am definitely of the opinion that we should lay low. And what's great is the way that we're doing it now, we're not like sending messages to them. What we're doing is we're like detectives. We're just sitting in our cars with our, you know, cold coffee and our crappy donuts. And we're able to look for, we're staking it out. It's a cosmic stakeout, basically. And with these new powerful telescopes, yeah, we have a way of actually watching just for them, going about them about their business. And that's what this book is about. It's about a fun, fast way to see how close we are to actually getting some evidence for life in the universe.
You're a funny astrophysicist. I got to give it to you.
The funniest one we've met on this show.
Yes.
Well, that's good. I'm glad.
Is there a chance that the physics of some other world is so different that they don't need our water or our diamonds or whatever it is they'd want to invade us for?
Yeah, you know, the whole idea of the invasion thing, I have a whole chapter in there where I talk about how much our ideas about aliens have been affected by science fiction, right? And, yeah, and, you know, kind of the UFO conspiracy stuff and then science fiction. And, of course, behind me is the Enterprise, right?
Yeah.
That's my Enterprise, by the way, you know, my generation's Enterprise. So, you know, one of the things that's really exciting now in the science that my group is doing and others are doing is we're going beyond that. We're trying to think about life as we don't know it, right? That's the only way we're really going to be able to find anything. So thinking about non-carbon-based life, thinking about life with whose minds are completely different from ours, whose biological, their setups are completely, how they look, completely different. And we can do that finally. And that's what I'm trying to tell people is like, you know, we're finally, it's not your grandfather's search for alien life anymore.
Right.
So real quickly though, so you don't believe any of these videos that people send in to TMZ?
No, you can see there's an interesting thing that the government panel that was set up actually looked at a lot of those and found that only about 3% are actually unexplained. The other 97%, it's like, oh, it's an airplane. So the sky is not full of stuff we don't understand. So there are a few that are freaky deaky, but, you know, mostly they're explainable.
So he's saying there's a chance. All right, for more, you can check out AdamFrankScience.com or follow Adam on X. And his book is The Little Book of Aliens. Thank you so
much.
Thanks,
Adam.
Thank you. It's great talking to you guys.
You too.